Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Sonali. Welcome to my channel if you guys are new, and if you are, definitely hit that subscribe button. And if you are already subscribed, make sure your post notifications are on so you guys don't miss a video. Today I thought I would do like a get ready with me. I'm gonna be shooting some really exciting content later today. I don't remember the last time I put on an Indian outfit, and the sari room sent over like a lehenga. And I was like so excited when they reached out. I think the last time I bought an Indian outfit was for like a wedding when I was maybe in high school. I honestly can't even remember. But I thought this would be like, oh my God, this hair is just not it. I thought today I could just do like a get ready with me and just be super chill, talk to you guys, girl chat, all of that. I feel like I get questions a lot about just like my experiences being an Indian woman and growing up Indian. And so I thought I could talk about a couple of those topics while we sit here and get ready with each other. Also, I wanted to show you guys this cute freaking mirror I got off Etsy. I've seen them in like TikToks and stuff, just like those aesthetic TikToks. So I decided that I had to have one myself. If you guys are interested in it, I'll leave the link in the description box, but super cute. Okay, so let's get started. It's time to decide what foundation I'm gonna be using. Let's see. I got a NARS one right here. I have my tried and true L'Oreal, what is this? L'Oreal Paris Pro Glow. Yes, I think I'm gonna darken it. Perfect. I think it was a little too bright. Like I said, the Makeup Forever HD stick, and then this one is amazing, and honestly, I kind of want to try this one. I'm not sure if it's gonna be too dark for me, but we can always like lighten it up with concealer, but I freaking love this. It is the Airbrush Flawless Foundation from Charlotte Tilbury. My mind is blanking today. I'm gonna go wet my beauty blender and I'll be right back. It's a little dark, but you know, we'll make it work. I just really love the formula and it's perfect for like a full coverage glam look, I guess. Let's start off talking about, I guess, like growing up being Indian. I feel like I really only realized that I was like different because of the mean comments kids would say. Like, kids are so ruthless when they're young and like they just don't have a filter and they would just say anything. So like, I think I just like knew I was like incredibly hairy. Like, that sounds so weird, but I was just so hairy growing up and I was like, what the frick? Like, I have hair everywhere on my body. And so I started waxing when I was really, really young. It's getting so bright, which is good. We love the sun, but I started waxing when I was really, really young. And then I eventually got laser hair removal, and thank goodness for my parents for like allowing me to do that, first of all, and paying for my sessions, because that shit is not cheap. And I definitely want to do it again because especially on my mustache, like it grows back pretty fast. I got laser hair removal everywhere, but it was so helpful because it lightened like the growth and I don't have to shave as often. Also, this is kind of weird, but whenever I show my armpits like in my TikToks or whatever, so many people ask me like, how do I get my armpits so light? Okay, this is so weird, but here's my armpits. And I'm pretty sure it was from laser hair removal. Like, I think it was because of that. And so I think laser hair removal is so worth it. It's probably more worth it if you're like older. I feel like I got it in like a stage where I was still like developing, I guess. So I think I just need more sessions. But also the pain level, I have a incredibly high pain tolerance because I had to start waxing and threading when I was so freaking young. So I don't really think it like hurt. It was definitely like uncomfortable, especially on certain places. Honestly, my favorite motto is beauty is pain. You just gotta get through it because it's something that's gonna like be so worth it in the end. So yeah, I just was a very hairy kid. And you know what's funny? Ryan is a very hairy man too. So if we ever have kids, God bless our child, because it's gonna be a hairy one. Speaking of my boyfriend, Ryan, I do get a lot of questions. Oh, I'm using the Huda Beauty Tantor bronzer cream, and I stopped using it for a while, but then I came back to it because it's just like so good. And it gives you like such a defined contour. I find that since I am darker skin, a powder contour or a powder bronzer doesn't do shit for me, and it like literally disappears in like 2 seconds. So this one really stays on my face. But anyways, I have a boyfriend, he is white, and a lot of people always ask me like how my parents reacted to that, I guess. A little bit about my parents. My dad was born in Bombay. I think I get those two mixed up. I want to say he was born in Bombay and then he moved to Bangalore. So like, he was raised in Bangalore, I think. And then my mom is, she was born in Chicago, actually, but her family is from Kerala, so I'm South Indian, and she actually went to boarding school because her dad died when she was really young. And so she was basically raised in India, and then she went to college in India where my parents met. And then my dad came back here to the States with my mom after college. Now they are divorced. They got divorced my freshman year of college. So that was a very interesting thing because I'm not gonna lie, it was just like a weird thing to see because you don't really see divorce in the Indian community very often. Before that, like when I was growing up, my dad, I wouldn't say they were strict, but I definitely thought they were stricter than I guess maybe they were. All my parents wanted was for me to do good in school. And obviously I feel like that's a lot of parents. But I like felt like I could never talk about boys because I feel like that was weird. I'm gonna go in with a concealer. I probably should have done this first. I thought they were like a lot more strict than I guess maybe they were. But I always thought like education comes first, and obviously like that is true. I actually started dating my boyfriend my sophomore year of high school. So we have been together like for 8 years now. And I hid my boyfriend for like a good 2 years before telling my parents because I felt like, okay, once I get into college, like, you know, that's all they wanted, like for me to go to college and get into college and just focus on my education. So like once I'm done with these stupid SATs and ACTs, that was like the worst time of my life. And honestly, if that's the worst time of my life, then I'm doing pretty good. I literally hated my parents for like a whole summer because they put me in this, what's it called? C2. Oh, it's like SAT prep. It was Monday through Thursday, 9 a.m. to like 4 p.m. my whole freaking summer. I literally wanted to die every day. But yeah, so basically they were like super focused on me doing well in my scores and everything like that. And I'm not gonna lie, like I don't think I was ever really like book smart. And so I didn't really do like amazing on my SATs. I mean, I obviously got into college and I went to UCF in Orlando, Central Florida. So I think I did fine on my SATs and ACTs. I definitely could have done better if I applied myself more, but I literally hated it so much. My mom found out from like another mom, or like she was talking to like one of her friends, and the friend said something about like, oh, does your daughter have a boyfriend or whatever? And then I don't know, she like was like, oh yeah, she asked me, and I was like, yeah. It was like so nonchalant and very anticlimactic. And then once I went to college, I called my dad. I was like, oh yeah, I would love for you to meet my boyfriend when I come home. He was like, okay. It was so anticlimactic. I was like, all right, like, because I'm pretty sure they like freaking knew, like, you know, I went to like homecoming and prom with this man. So once they found out, they were like fine with it. I mean, now they like freaking love Ryan. And how can you not love Ryan? Because he's just such a good person. And honestly, I don't know who else could put up with me. So, and I know my family knows that too. And I'm really thankful that I didn't have to deal with anything too crazy. I'm gonna go in with this brow pencil. I love these like really cheap like brow pencils. Wet n Wild, there's another one from LA Girl, I think. They're honestly so much creamier than the Anastasia Beverly Hills ones. I got my brows done for the first time in so long. And oh my God, I felt like a new person. And also I only get my brows threaded by, you know, my girls at Hollywood Beauty. Pretty sure they're all Indian or like brown. And you know what's funny? Every time I go into a brow place, or like Cherry Ann's back in Atlanta, like an Indian grocery store, I feel like they're always playing like really old Indian music that I know. And like, I don't even watch really Bollywood movies anymore, which honestly, that was a goal of mine to watch like one a month. I'm not doing so great, but I really want to get back into that because I feel like I've just been really distant with my culture lately. And I'm honestly not proud of it because I love my culture. I just feel like I'm not surrounded by Indians. And that's another thing. I never in my schools, like in my elementary school, middle school, high school, college, I was never surrounded by Indian people. And honestly, I kind of regret like not getting more into Bollywood dance. I did that for a couple years. I wonder if I could like insert a video. I'm gonna try to see if my mom will send me one. I was like such a bad dancer. I just like never showed any facial expressions. And I was a cheerleader actually for quite a while. And I would never smile when I cheered. And then senior year, my mom showed me like a photo of me. She took a photo of me when I was cheering. And I was like so shocked because I literally looked like I was like a dead person cheering. So I started to smile. And actually I have like the worst resting bitch face. When you go into the Indian grocery store and everything, I feel like they always play like really old Indian songs. Is that because like there's not any good new Indian music? Or is it kind of like playing like Living on the Prayer on the radio? Like, is it like that much of a classic? If you guys have watched any Bollywood movies recently and you think they're really, really good, please comment them down below. I need all the suggestions I can get. Bonus points if it's on Netflix, Hulu, or you can just get it free anywhere. I also have Amazon Prime, but I feel like a lot of that stuff you have to pay for. But yeah, I definitely want to get back into that because I love like Bollywood music. I do have like a Hindi playlist on my Spotify, and I'll turn it on with Ryan in the car sometimes and we'll just like jam out. But I did make him watch Dostana because, you know, the famous song Desi Girl is in that movie, and I've definitely played it for him before that. We did watch Om Shanti Om. I don't know if it was like his first Hindi movie ever, but I want to say so because of the way he reacted. But if you've watched Om Shanti Om, Shah Rukh Khan is in it, which is literally like the biggest Bollywood star ever. And he is just like overacting, but I never really understood like that he was, because Bollywood movies are cheesy, like we all know that, you know? But I never like heard that verbalized until Ryan was like, why is he like so cheesy? Why is he like overacting? But like in the movie, he's like an actor, or like wanting to be an actor, so he's like making it cheesy. That was really interesting, just hearing his perspective on Indian movies. And he doesn't love musicals like, you know, Hairspray or like The Greatest Showman. So I was very curious to see if he would like Indian movies, because literally they are all musicals. But I think he pretty much liked them. But that is one of my like things that I hate about Bollywood movies, because y'all know I don't like to read. And you basically have to read a freaking novel when you're watching a Bollywood movie if you don't understand the language, which I don't. And I don't speak anything else but English. I mean, I took Spanish in high school and college, but I barely remember anything. And so I have always wished I could speak Hindi, and like obviously you still can, you can still learn, but it's just so much harder like as an adult. So I downloaded a few apps. Like I had this one phase that I really wanted to start learning just like here and there, like, you know, words. But some of the apps, like, it doesn't have the word written in English. It has it written in the Hindi language, or like Sanskrit, I think it's called. And I'm like, I don't even know what the word is like in English. How can I translate it? Like, I was just so confused. So I just kind of gave up. But I'm gonna use the Friendcation palette. I'm gonna go in with this color and just kind of set a base on my eyelids. I feel like I'm so distracted. I don't even know what I'm doing to my face right now, but hopefully it turns out good, because I want it to be like super glam. Not that I'm getting engaged super soon. Trust me, I'm not. But I feel like I should talk about my future wedding, because I've been dreaming about it my freaking whole life. So I definitely want to do something like American Indian fusion, because obviously I want my culture to be a part of it. I think it's just such a beautiful culture, and I don't know, I'm just so excited about it. So my plan is to have a normal like American wedding dress, but then for my reception I'll do an outfit change into the most gaudiest lehenga, and I'm gonna be like shining. You could see me from space with like the beaded details. I just have like a vision, and I feel like it could be easy for me to like dance in, you know, on the dance floor. And I think that would be so freaking pretty. And then I also want to have like a mehndi night, but I kind of want that to be like my bridal shower. Maybe like I'll do it like way before, so I don't actually have the mehndi on my hands with my American dress, because I feel like it definitely looks so pretty when you're actually at a Hindu wedding, you know, like, but I don't really want it for my wedding day. But I think mehndi, also known as henna, is just so freaking cool. So I definitely want to do it with my friends and like celebrate and do like a little mehndi night. And then speaking of religion, I'm not sure if you guys even care, but my dad is Hindu and my mom is Catholic, and I was raised Catholic. So I actually have been confirmed. I did like the whole nine yards. But I'm not really super religious. Like, I definitely still pray a lot, but I don't go to church. I don't go to mass anymore. But it's so funny because, like, my dad didn't really practice Hinduism. Like, he didn't go to the temple. But I feel like that's where a lot of, like, my favorite cultural memories came from, doing, like going to Diwali. And so sometimes I would feel like I wish I was Hindu, so I still had, like, those events to go to, and I still could go, but I honestly just don't know where to meet Indian friends that are still connected to their culture, because I feel like all the people I met aren't really super connected. And maybe that's just like our generation, and I just think it's so sad, and I really just want to like get back into it, but I honestly just don't know how. Also, every Sunday my mom would take me to mass, me and my sister, and my dad would like be sitting on the couch watching golf, and I thought that was like what Hinduism was, not actually, like, it was a joke. I was like, I want to be Hindu so I could like sit here and watch TV and not go to mass, you know? But I mean, obviously I'm so freaking grateful for my mom taking me to church every day, because I feel like that's where a lot of my morals come from, and I feel like if I didn't have that foundation, I don't know who I would be today, you know? So I'm really, really thankful that I got that kind of experience. But I also do wonder, like, oh, what would life be if I was Hindu and I, like, had that kind of background, you know? I feel like it would definitely be a little different. I love this Glossier Pro Tip eyeliner. I think everything about it is just perfect. So we're gonna try a wing. Wish me luck. In the past, I've gotten a lot of questions about if I've experienced any racial hate, especially with all the Asian hate crime going on right now, which is actually like so saddening. And I will definitely leave some links down below for where you can donate, which I'll be doing too. The other day, me and Ryan were talking about the Asian hate crimes, and I told him that I never really felt like I experienced anything like that. And he said that, like, you know, in the malls when we would walk together in high school or college or whatever, he would get stares from like older, you know, white people, or like just older people in general, just like kind of like eyeing us down. And I don't know if it was like because, you know, we were interracial, like I don't know why they were eyeing us down, but like obviously they were just staring. And I never knew that. He literally just told me that, and I thought it was very interesting because I'm just like so naive that I'm not looking at around, and maybe I don't want to, you know, because like what can I do about just someone staring at me? And like, thank God that's like the worst it's been. Okay, actually now I'm remembering a story that I have to tell you guys. Let me finish my eyeliner and then I'll tell you guys the story. Decided against doing wings because I'm just a little afraid it's gonna be all wonky since my eyeliner was acting up. So we're just gonna stick to a normal eyeliner look. Okay, so me and Ryan went to tubing in Helen, Georgia. And when we were like coming back to our car on the bus, this woman was like, oh my God, you have such a like beautiful complexion. And I was like, oh my God, thank you, that's so sweet. And she was like, what ethnicity are you? And I said Indian. And she said, oh, the red dot Indian or the feathers Indian? I think I could have killed someone with the stare I gave her. I could not believe that she said that, and I just like stared at her. I didn't even say anything. And she was like, oh, sorry, like I didn't mean it like that. I'm like, what did you mean it as? Like, what? And I was just like, okay, yeah, no, it's okay. Like, what the heck? Who in their right mind says that kind of shit? Also, can we talk about how I feel like everything that I have been bullied for as a kid, you know, being Indian, being hairy, wearing mehndi, is that marker on your hand? No, it's freaking henna. I know, if you're Indian, you probably definitely got that comment growing up. But I feel like all that stuff is so trendy. Well, to be tan, I don't know if that would be like trendy, but when I was young, my grandpa visited us from India. He brought my sister and I like bottles of Fair and Lovely. And if you don't know what Fair and Lovely is, it's like a lotion that bleaches your skin. I don't even know how it does that, but people use it in India to be more fair. I actually did use it a couple of times because he was like, yeah, I use this, like, you know, it's good to be fair, blah, blah, like, and I was always, always, always taught to stay out of the sun. And I honestly like did, but you know, I did get pretty dark in the summers. I just never liked my brown skin, and not like my brown skin, but I liked being fair, and I didn't like getting dark in the summers. And so I would like cover myself in towels, like at the beach every single time. I remember my sorority had a, not a new member retreat, but like a whole, like, you know, the sorority went to a beach. And I was like the only one that brought an umbrella. I don't know, like no one else had an umbrella. Everyone else was like laying out in the sun, enjoying the sun. And I was just like, like I kind of need this, you know? It ended up like blowing over, so I didn't even like put it up because I could not get it up. But it was kind of embarrassing because I was like the only one with like an umbrella lugging it out to the beach. Also, we went through a phase where henna was like super trendy, and I just remember so many annoying comments. Not even like me, but kids are curious and they just like make like funny jokes that aren't so funny to me, you know? I'm just like, shut up, like I already told you it was like henna, you know? But they just don't understand. They're like, no, that's definitely marker, you definitely drew it on your hand. Like, no, I told you what I told you, like it's henna. Now I love my tan because I'm so grateful that I don't have to self-tan. And if you guys saw my video over Christmas holidays, I tried self-tanning my face just to get a more even complexion, and it didn't really help the unevenness. It did give me like a really pretty color, which I like because sometimes my face is a lot more pale than my body. I do love my tan now, and like in the summer I'm just so excited to get dark because I think it's just so pretty. You're like sun-kissed, you like feel good, you feel confident. And I am really just sad that like I spent all those years wanting to be pale, and I don't know. And now in the winter, when I do get pale, I'm like, oh shit, like I feel like I need to get some sun, you know? It's just funny how things change as you grow up and you really start to like embrace everything about you and everything about your culture. Another question I get asked about is if I experienced any racism in Greek life through my sorority. And Absolutely not. I never did. I will say though, when I went through recruitment, I was going through everyone's Instagram, every sorority's Instagram, and trying to find someone my color. Because I literally thought they didn't let like brown people like me in. So I finally found like one black girl here, one like ethnic looking girl here. She might have been Hispanic or like Persian or something. That just gave me so much hope. And now hearing girls saying like, oh, it's so cool to see an Indian woman on TV in this specific role because that means like I could be that one day, or like I could get a role like that one day, or even seeing like a brown person as a CEO of like a crazy cool company, that just gives you so much hope. And I really understand that now, since I like went through that. I'm not sure about other sororities and other schools, but I definitely know at UCF, I feel like Greek life as a whole is just getting so much more diverse, which is amazing. I just feel like people of color are just more comfortable going through recruitment, because they started to see diversity and it kind of picked up, and they got that hope that they could join too and like have a really great experience. So I'm really, really happy to see that. And if you guys didn't know, I was PR for my sorority for like 2 years. Honestly, that was my biggest goal, was to show our diversity, because we had stunning girls that never made it to the Instagram. I don't know why, but they just never did. And I was like, okay, that's weird. Like, they need to be on the Instagram like yesterday because they're stunning. They like hold positions. They like do so much for our chapter, like why aren't we showing these girls, you know? And then in the back of my mind, obviously for recruitment, when that rolled around, I wanted to show other women of color that we do have women of color in our sorority, and that, you know, it's not all one ethnicity. I'm so mad, I was gonna put on fake lashes, but I just did my mascara fully, so I guess we won't be doing that. But honestly, maybe that was fate, because God knew that my eyelashes were gonna like come off the corners during my shoot, so it's okay. I'll just like curl them every second of my shoot. Let's talk about race in the influencer industry, because I thought this was very interesting during the Black Lives Matter movement. You know, after that all happened, I saw so many companies really trying to use black women to show across their platforms, you know, getting them sponsorships here and there, which is amazing. But also I felt as though they were like checking off a box because all this stuff just happened. And I read this really good article. I will try to link it down below, but I literally can't remember where it was from. And I don't know where maybe my boss sent it to me. I'm not really even sure. But anyways, there was this article and it interviewed 3 black influencers, and it was asking them like how they really felt about like the influencer industry at the peak of the BLM movement. And they were like, yeah, like, I mean, obviously it's great that people are starting to actually pay attention to us, but also like, we feel like we're just being used. And like, you can take that either way, being the person that's, you know, getting the sponsorships. Like, you're like, okay, well, like, you know, let's say Target reached out to me. Like, that's one of my dream brands to work with. Like, how did this happen? But like, they're just kind of using you to like check a box off. And to be totally transparent with you guys, one of my keywords on my media page, like the first cover page, is like a lot of photos and just like a lot of keywords about like my brand and, you know, all of that kind of stuff. And one of the words is women of color, because I wonder if that could like get me more sponsorships. So sometimes, like, you know, it's great to have that to make you stand out, I guess. But also you kind of just sit there and you're wondering like, okay, like, do they actually like my content, or do they just need me to check off a box, like I said? So it was like really interesting to just read that article. Using my tried and true Hoola bronzer to contour my nose a bit more. Sometimes I'll get messages from brown girls just saying how it's really cool for them to see an influencer, micro influencer, whatever you want to call me, that's also brown. And that just goes back to that feeling that you're like, wow, there's hope for me. And like, I see her wearing this color, so like that would look good on my skin tone. And just like getting advice and inspiration on what to wear, maybe like makeup wise and everything like that. It's just really cool to hear that. But sometimes I feel like I need to be talking more about my culture. Like, sometimes I feel like I don't do enough of it, and it just makes me really sad. I honestly wish I was more connected to my culture, and I definitely need to work on that. Like, that's something that takes effort for sure. One of my biggest fears is that if me and Ryan get married and we have kids, that they won't have those same cultural experiences that I had as a child, because my dad was Hindu and he was very, very connected within the Indian community, and still is to this day. Like I said, it's definitely going to take a lot of effort for me to even like meet other Indian people here that maybe are more connected to their culture and can like invite me to like Diwali functions and all that. I just like miss dressing up in Indian clothes so much. When I was growing up, obviously we went to like Diwali functions and like Indian functions here and there, and Indians love to dance. Not everyone does, but you know, majority of them do. And I was one of them that did not want to dance ever. I would just like sit in the ballroom, like on my phone and talking to my Indian family friends. But I hated dancing. But now that I'm like old enough, I feel like it's not as embarrassing to dance around my parents. Like, it was fun. The last wedding I went to, like, me and my sister danced. It also might have been because I had a little bit of liquid courage in me, so that probably helped. But still, it was really fun, and I'm just really excited for the next Indian wedding I go to, or just like wedding in general. Also, I did mention that I had Indian family friends, and I am still really close to a lot of them to this day. Like, whenever I go home, I try to see them. And two of my Indian family friends visited their friends here, but we got to see each other like a couple times, so that was really fun. But when I said that I wasn't like surrounded by Indian people a lot, it was just like in the school system, so like seeing them every day, I didn't see that. Before I forget, let me tell you guys what color I am and everything. So the foundation, I was a 12 Cool Freud. That's what it's called. And then for the concealer, it was golden beige. And what else? Oh, I forgot to show you guys the eyeshadow. I literally use this on a daily, so like, I don't know, this might be my everyday makeup. It might be full glam to some people, like, I don't know, but this is the one I use on the daily. I'm not even sure if it's sold anymore. It's the Laura Mercier baked like eye color in terracotta. Look how freaking pretty that is. Now it's time to talk about my favorite brown lip combo. This is all you freaking need in your life for now, until I find like the next best like lip liner, you know. But okay, this is from Makeup Forever. It is the Artist Color Pencil. The color is Limitless Brown 608. So I'm just gonna line my lips. I did put chapstick on before it, so it might be a little bit more creamy than usual, but gotta have those lips a little bit moisturized before doing this. So just like smack that around. That's what that looks like. Now we're gonna go in with the Dose of Colors liquid lipsticks. This is like one of my favorite liquid lipsticks, but the other one is Jeffree Star Celebrity Skin. It's like a more pale pink, not pink. It's like a more just pale color. I don't know how to describe it, but this is like almost like a nude. So this one is Knock on Wood, and it looks like brown in the container, but it's like not brown on my lips. I hate that. Like when you see a really good lip liner or lipstick in the store, cause like the packaging looks like it would be a good color for you, and then you put it on and it's like a pink. I'm like, hello. And I feel like every lipstick collection is just all pinks, you know? There's like never a brown, or if there is, it's like a pinky brown or like a really dark brown. And I just need like a good nude neutral brown, you know? I'm just gonna go put it like just right in the middle of my lips and just smack it around. Okay, how pretty is that? You can wait a minute and then it's gonna be a matte lip and just leave it matte, which is a really pretty look. Or you can take some gloss and top it off, which I'm gonna be doing. So this is the Maybelline Gloss Hyaluronic Acid, and it is in the color Stone 008. Looks like this. It kind of looks pinky, but it's okay because it's a gloss, so it's really pretty on top. My makeup is done. I just have to retouch my hair. It's already been curled yesterday, but just gonna retouch it. This is my final look. This outfit is from the Sari Room, and I was actually surprised because I did take my measurements. Indian clothes like usually are actually like tailored to the person, especially if you're going to like a really special occasion like a wedding. Surprisingly, this pretty much fit right out of the package, which is great. I actually got a medium on the skirt. I took my measurements with like a tape measure, so always do that. Highly recommend doing that if you're ever ordering online. You should just always have like your measurements and your notes phone on your app. So I decided to go with the medium because I knew that the lingo was gonna be very, very high-waisted, and I felt like my waist is pretty small, so I just, you know, went with that. And then the top, I'm pretty sure I got it a large. What's cool about this top is that it has a zipper in the back. I feel like when I was growing up wearing Indian outfits, they never had zipper tops like this, so I feel like that's really convenient. They would always like have something like tied or like a lace that you would have to really like adjust, which it's nice to be more adjustable, but a zipper is also very convenient. This is the outfit, and I feel like Sari Room, if you like look at their brand, they like to like mix and match the skirts, and they're pretty affordable. If you're brown, you would know that Indian outfits are so expensive. When I would go to India, which was not very often at all, we would go and get like custom Indian outfits, And we would get maybe like 3 at a time, and we would outfit repeat because they're so expensive. And also my mom and my sister was, you know, kind of around the same size, so we could like kind of like switch around. But I did get to like repurpose some of their outfits. I'll put a couple pictures up of my past Indian outfits on the screen because I feel like they just need a couple minutes to shine because they were all so beautiful and just so intricate. This skirt has this like floral threaded design, and the top has this really nice gold beaded detail. I'm so excited to shoot this look. I will share some of the photos that I took right now. That wraps up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed getting to know me better and my cultural experiences. I would love for you to share your experiences in the comments down below, especially if you guys had some similar experiences to mine. If you guys aren't following me on Instagram, go ahead and do so. My @ name is @so_gnarly without G. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.